Hello. In the penultimate Round Britain quiz of the season, we welcome back the teams from Wales and Northern Ireland for their last fixture. It could be a chance for Polly Devlin and Brian Feeney of Northern Ireland to turn the tables on Myfanwy, Alexander and David Edwards of Wales following their last encounter. Or Wales could make it a clean sweep with four victories in this series. We'll let them loose in a moment, but first there's a small matter of the cliffhanger question from last week. You might remember I asked in what sense a beautiful cupbearer, the mother of King Minos of Crete, a priestess transformed into a cow, and a nymph transformed into a bear, all now encircle their lover. Well, in the sense that their names have been given to the four largest moons of Jupiter, they are respectively Ganymede, Io, Europa, and Callisto. All of them named for characters beloved of Zeus or his Roman equivalent, Jupiter, in mythology. But we turn now to the great gas giants of the Round Britain quiz arena. Remember, each question has a maximum 6 points attached, and the more hints I have to give you, the more points I'll be docking. Myfanwy and David, could you start us off? And your first question comes from Hugh Jones in London. I don't know whether you're reassured by the Welshness of that name, but this is his question. What in the UK links a southern belle, part of a fantasy game, a fishhawk, and a melancholy musical genre? What in the UK links a southern belle, part of a fantasy game, a fishhawk, and a melancholy musical genre?
Well, I suggest that the question is Welsh. Indications are no coincidence, possibly here. We think we're talking about Welsh rugby-playing regions.
Just explain.
The Southern Belle would possibly be Scarlet O'Hara, and that represents Llanelli Scarlets that, represent the region of western North Wales.
The fantasy game that... There are several fantasy games that spring to mind, but I'm old enough to remember when pretty well the only fantasy game in town was Dungeons and Dragons. So we get the Gwent Dragons,
Newport
Gwent Dragons.
Yeah. Newport Dragons is what I've got written here, yes.
Fishhawk will be the Ospreys, or at one time the Neath Swansea Ospreys.
Yeah. Very good. And finally?
The musical genre, the blues, as in Cardiff Blues.
Cardiff Blues, yes.
Many people have the blues in Cardiff, but the rugby team is just one of them.
Okay, well, you tried and you converted 6 points. The four franchises at the upper level of Welsh rugby. So they've thrown down a gauntlet to Northern Ireland. Can you come back? This is your question. Which Roman emperor connects Tamora's vengeful enemy, the son of Sepulchrave and the Popish plot? Which Roman emperor connects Tamora's vengeful enemy, the son of Sepulchrave and the Popish plot?
The Popish plot, are we talking about Titus Oates?
You are.
Or just his name, or a wider conspiracy? Or
yeah, you've started well.
So are we going on the Tituses?
So that would be a good plan.
So are we going to Mervyn Peak?
I don't know, you tell me.
Is it Gormenghast?
Which bit?
Oh, a Sepulchrave.
Yeah, and why would that be?
Is Titus Groan is the son of Sepulchrave.
Yep. Thank you, yes, that's what I was looking for. Titus Groan is the son of Sepulchrave.
So Titus Oates, Titus Grave, and the Roman Emperor is Titus.
Yes, but you're missing Tamora's vengeful enemy.
Oh, Titus... Is it part of a play? Is it a dramatic character?
Part of a play described by T.S. Eliot as one of the stupidest and most uninspired plays ever written.
So is it written?
But a great hit in its writer's day.
Was it Christopher Fry?
No.
But it was written at the time of T.S. Eliot. So it's an earlier play. Is it one of the?
I think T.S. Eliot objected to its bloodiness. It's a singularly bloody.
Oh, well, it's not Shakespeare, but it can't be Coriolanus.
It is Shakespeare.
Is it Titus? Timon of Athens? Or is it Coriolanus?
No.
The bloody play. Twelfth Night's funny.
Not terribly often performed now, but.
Titus.
If you start with Titus, that might help.
Titus Andronicus. Sorry. It's not obvious. Titus and it wasn't to us, wasn't it?
I think it'll be obvious to quite a lot of listeners, but yes. For some reason it wasn't obvious
to you.
All right,
so Titus Andronicus...
the Roman emperor is Titus, connects Tamora's vengeful enemy is Titus Andronicus, who actually feeds her children to her in a pie in Titus Andronicus. The son of Sepulchrave is Titus Groan, the heir to Gormenghast, and the popish plot was created by Titus Oates. I'm afraid I have to penalise you for that taking so long to get to the name Titus Andronicus, so I think I can only give you 4 points for that, Northern Ireland. So Wales, time for a music question. Have a listen to these clips and see if you can explain the connection.
Come over the window, my little darling, I'd like to try to read your poem. I used to think I was some kind of gypsy boy before I let you take me.
So, Wales, I don't think you get a huge number of points for identifying those pieces, but can you put them together in a context?
Tricky. Well, shall we identify them first?
Yeah.
Right.
I think I know the connection.
Right, brilliant. Right.
You've got to it just in time, okay?
Are we looking at national emblems? Because we have Marianne, Britannia, and Uncle Sam.
You are. Just identify the pieces for me as well. I'm going to make you work a tiny bit harder for your...
Right, well, the middle one is Rule Britannia, which was written by Thomas Arne in the 18th century.
That's right. So...
The first is Canada's greatest ever export, Leonard Cohen, singing Marianne.
It is, yes. And then finally, the last piece?
Well, it was called Say Uncle Sam.
It was called that. Do you know who was performing it?
Very little idea, actually.
No.
It's a kind of thing I would instinctively avoid if it came on the jukebox.
I don't think you can get there by process of deduction. Madness.
Madness?
Oh, was it? Should have known then. Should have known. Yep.
Familiar voice. But anyway.
Didn't spot it.
No.
I don't think I can dock any points for that. You absolutely got the central principle there. We played Leonard Cohen's So Long, Marianne, Rule Britannia, and Madness's Uncle Sam, and the connection was... just to make you go the final inch, you could need to tell me the nationalities of those various symbols. I don't think you're going to find this difficult.
Well, Marianne's the symbol of the French Revolution, and so the French Republic.
Right.
Britannia of Britannia.
And Uncle Sam represents the United States.
Yeah, I thought it would have been remarkable if you'd stumbled at that point. You didn't, so 6 points to you, Wales. So, Northern Ireland, what cause should the author of Trouble at Willow Gables and Michaelmas Term at St Bride's have to dislike Danger Mouse's arch-enemy, one whose life was changed by a poop-poop, and Mr Jackson? What cause should the author of Trouble at Willow Gables and Michaelmas Term at St Bride's have to dislike Danger Mouse's arch-enemy, one whose life was changed by a poop-poop, and Mr Jackson?
So, one whose life was changed by a poop-poop, is that Mr. Toad?
It is Mr. Toad, yes.
So, are we going
just
on...
explain why that gets you to Mr. Toad. I mean, I think most listeners will know, but...
Great moment in literary history where he hears this noise. He's knocked over by a motor car and falls totally in love with the whole idea of the glittering machine. So, that's Mr. Toad. So, are we going on reptiles or animals like that?
Yes, there's a consistency here.
So, is Mr. Jackson Is there a turtle in here?
No.
So Danger Mouse's arch enemy, is that a snake?
No.
But it's something that's trying to gobble him at all times. Is this in a cartoon? Danger Mouse is a cartoon.
It is a cartoon, yes. And all of these three are, in fact...
cartoon characters.
Well, cartoon or fictional.
So Mr. Jackson, his first name is the whole point, isn't it?
No, the first name isn't the point. Think of Beatrix Potter.
Oh, in the Tales of Peter Rabbit and... Mr. Jackson, he's not the gardener, is he?
No, he's not, no.
Did he bake him in a pie?
No, it's not that story. It's not Samuel Whiskers. It's the Tale of Mrs. Tittlemouse. I don't know whether that helps you at all.
I don't know what she did to him.
We don't.
What about the stories, The Trouble at Willow Gables and Michaelmas Term at St. Bride's? What does that suggest to you?
So that's a sort of cartoon as well.
No, that's they're sort of short stories and novellas at best, I think.
But they're not. No, Billy Bunter isn't.
No, they sound rather innocent. They're not entirely as innocent as they first appear.
Oh, are they crime thrillers?
No.
I mean, are we looking at things like rats and mice and?
I'll give you the fact that you're looking at toads.
All toads.
I don't know the names of all the toads.
And I don't know whether that would help you with the author of Trouble at Willow Gables and Michaelmas Term at St. Bride's. Not characteristic works, those, but private works later published.
So his name is a species of toad?
No. The author of, much better known, High Windows...
At High Windows is Philip Larkin. Oh, the toad work. Yeah.
We've got to his toad, yes.
Oh, so The Trouble at Willow Gables and Michaelmas Term at St. Bride's were his little porn magazines that were taken up and made somebody... He really nearly resigned over it, didn't he?
Well, they were salacious fantasies. About girls' schools. So I don't think you're going to be able to tell me. No. I mean, I've had to give you Danger Mouse's archenemy. Danger Mouse is Baron Greenback in the children's cartoon series. And Mr. Jackson is the toad who invites himself for tea in Beatrix Potter's The Tale of Mrs. Tittlemouse and comes in because he smells honey and generally behaves badly. So you had some problem with that. I'm afraid I think I can only give you 2 points for that, Northern Ireland. The reason the author of Trouble at Willow Gables and Michaelmas Term at St. Bride's would have disliked Danger Mouse's archenemy, one who his life was changed by a poop poop and Mr. Jackson, is because they are all toads, and Philip Larkin famously wrote the poem, Toads, Why Should I Let the Toad Work Squat on My Life? Wales. I hope you have better luck with this question. From a listener this time, this is from Peter Effer in Walthamstow in London. In what way do Margot Ledbetter, the final resting place of the Royal Yacht Britannia, the site of Newgrange and Peter Haynes' old constituency sound like a progression? In what way do Margot Ledbetter, the final resting place of the Royal Yacht Britannia, the site of Newgrange and Peter Haynes' old constituency sound like a progression?
Right. Well, the resting place of the Royal Yacht, it's docked alongside the quay at Leith at Edinburgh.
That's correct.
Which could be a start, I think. Margot Ledbetter,
Margot Ledbetter, what a wonderfully named character, isn't it? It all comes back. She was played by, Good Life, isn't it? She's played by Penelope Keith.
That's right.
So we've got Keith and Leith. Newgrange is a burial chamber which is somewhere in the sort of north-eastern part of the Republic of Ireland, and I think it is in County Meath, which would certainly fit.
OK, and you may be able to arrive by deduction.
The final one is engraved on my mind in Letters of Fire, because people used to always say when he was representative of that constituency, he didn't get that complexion in Neath, you know. because not many people are quite so suntanned. So that gives us Peter Haynes' old constituency being Neath. So we've got a alphabetical progression.
But from, only phonetic.
Yes.
Exactly, yeah, yes. The spelling alters a little bit, but the sounds, as far as the sounds are concerned, it's a perfect progression.
Yeah, so it's K-L-M-N.
Exactly right. No points deducted at all, as far as I can see. So that's 6 to you, Wales. So, Polly and Brian, time for a music question for you. And while you're listening to this piece, think about this question. How could this music, a Danny Kaye ventriloquist comedy, A Hill in County Mayo, and Jules Romain's Rural Doctor, lead you to the US Bullion Depository? So, how could that music, a Danny Kaye ventriloquist comedy, A Hill in County Mayo, and Jules Romain's Rural Doctor, lead you to the US Bullion Depository?
The Hill in County Mayo is Croagh-Patrick? No?
It's not. We've been a tiny bit mischievous with this.
Okay.
Is it Ben Bulbin?
No.
That's in Sligo.
That's in Sligo. Is it, it's Fort Knox, is the...
You've got the right, you've got the US Bullion Depository, yep. So you've reached your destination, but you have to actually get to it by the right route.
So do all of them begin with forts? Are there forts of sorts?
No.
No.
What was the piece of music?
I keep writing down Oliver, Bugsy Malone, Annie.
Annie. Yeah. It's from Annie, it's from but that's Annie. Not its title, and you need the title.
It's A Hard Life.
Very close, but you've missed out the vital component.
Oh, it's a hard... Hard knock. Oh, so it's Knox.
It's a hard knock okay. life. So now, can you do any better with the other components?
Well, there's a knock is a big shrine in Mayo, and it's the hill is Knock. Well,
mm-hmm. You've got the shrine, but do you know why it's called Knock?
Well, because it comes from C-N-O-C, which is the Irish.
Exactly. Okay. Right. Yes, for the hill.
Yeah. Called the hill. Yes, the cock. Yeah. The ventriloquist comedy. He did Hans Christian Andersen. It's not Hans Christian Andersen.
No.
He did... is the School of Hard Knocks?
No. Common superstitious phrase, this.
A common superstitious... With knocks in it. We've got The Hill in County Mayo. Jules Romain's Rural Doctor is...
That's another one that you're waiting to get, but...
Yeah.
I think you should be able to work it out.
Is the comedy called Knock?
Yes, it is.
Is it Danny Vick ventriloquist comedy?
Oh, no, yes. No, that isn't. I'm sorry, I've got confused. The
So the Dr. Jules Romain's Rural Doctor is Dr. Knox.
Is Dr. Knock, and there's the comedy is called
and
Knock.
Fort Knox. And the comedy is called Knox.
One last chance for Danny Kaye. As I say, a very familiar, superstitious invocation.
Rap on wood.
Knock on wood. It's almost genius, Polly, the way that you avoid the word in question. The word literally in question.
Knock on wood.
Yes, knock on wood.
I'm sorry, I am half-witted sometimes.
So, we played you The Hard Knock Life from Annie and asked how that music, coupled with a Danny Kaye ventriloquist comedy, A Hill in County Mayo and Jules Romain's Rural Doctor, could lead you to the US Bullion Depository. The reason for that was that they were a series of knocks. The Hard Knock Life, the Danny Kaye ventriloquist comedy Knock on Wood, The Hill in County Mayo, as I say, we were slightly mischievous, it's the village of Knock. And finally, Jules Romain's Rural Doctor is Dr. Knock from a popular comedy he wrote, and that led you to knocks. Yeah, no, you don't get a gold bar for that. I don't think you even get a silver bar. Probably a lead bar, which is 2 points, I think, for you, Northern Ireland. So, Wales, this is your very last question of the series. You have, actually, if you get 6 on this, another chance to get a clean sweep. You got one earlier in the series. This idea comes from a listener, Sam Bright. What do Yossarian's Major, the cricketing father of footballers Phil and Gary, and the man serving a life sentence for the murder of Bobby Kennedy have in common with a buzzard, a fox and a badger? What do Yossarian's major, the cricketing father of footballers Phil and Gary, and the man serving a life sentence for the murder of Bobby Kennedy have in common with a buzzard, a fox and a badger?
And New York, New York. So and good they named them twice. The person arrested for and charged with the murder of Bobby Kennedy was, I think, Sirhan Sirhan.
Yep.
Phil and Gary Neville's father was...
Neville Neville.
Was called Neville Neville. He was kinder to his sons than his parents. Yes, in terms of, yeah. in terms of nomenclature,
careful,
at least.
My dad was Edward Edwards. So.
Well, yeah, as he might have been known, Neville squared. Neville to the power of Neville.
And he also had... another of his progeny was an England captain as well. His daughter, Tracy, was also
that's right.
England
yes,
Netball
Tracy
captain.
Neville. Yep. Yeah.
Then Yossarian's major. We're talking about Catch 22. Joseph Heller's Catch 22, yeah. I
yes.
think. And this actually is possibly so good they named him twice.
Yeah.
Because I think that if I remember correctly, not only was his first name Major, but his middle name was Major too.
Yeah.
So
was
he's actually
yes.
Major.
Exactly, yes. Once he was promoted, he became Major, yeah. Just spell it out. What do they? Why do they have that in common with a buzzard, a fox and a badger? I might press you here and see if you can...
Well, these are creatures whose Latin names are actually repetitions of themselves. Mm. So we've got a fox is Vulpus Vulpus. We think
Vulpes.
Yeah.
The buzzard, the taxonomic name for a buzzard is Butio Butio.
Very good. And it would be so sweet if you could get the final one here.
Well, we thought it's something like Meles, or something. It's starts with Mel.
It is Meles. Yes.
I don't know whether the sweet is significant. Does that come from honey?
I don't know immediately, but you would think it might well do.
I think it does, actually. Mm. I do think it does.
Well, you've done it again. I have to give you 6 for that. There's no reason at all to dock any points, so that's another clean sweep of 24 points, Wales. I asked you, what do Yossarian's major, actually known as Major, the cricketing father of footballers Phil and Gary, known as Neville Neville, and the man serving a life sentence for the murder of Bobby Kennedy, Sirhan Sirhan, have in common with a buzzard, a fox and a badger? They're all tautonyms. They're named twice over. Brilliantly done. 6 points to you. So, Northern Ireland. It's all for pride now. Explain how Retrospective Fury, A Song and Dance Man, The Diet of Worms and a lustful 18th century adventurer could lead you to a better class of person. Explain how Retrospective Fury, A Song and Dance Man, The Diet of Worms and a lustful 18th century adventurer could lead you to a better class of person.
It's a better class of person in terms of actual class, like gentry, or like a more reformed person?
Neither of those, in fact.
That's sad. So is A Song and Dance Man, that's not Tom Jones?
It isn't, but...
Is the 18th century adventurer Tom Jones?
The 18th century adventurer is Tom Jones, yes.
And the Song and Dance Man isn't Tom Jones? Please let it be Tom Jones.
No, it isn't.
Is he Fred Astaire?
No.
Has it something to do with Jones?
No, we're looking for a more generic description, I would say.
Can we go to the Diet of Worms? This was called to discuss the Reformation?
Yes, that's right. Convened by Charles V.
So is Luther?
Summoned.
Yeah, so are we...
Luther. Luther.
Mm-hmm. So it's not the actual content of the Diet of Worms. It's
I think your best place here to start is Retrospective Fury.
Yeah, but we can't get what that is.
If you can rephrase that, you might trigger something.
Anger about something that happened before.
Is it Look Back in Anger?
It is Look Back in Anger. Now.
Oh, and Archie Rice. Is it Archie Rice?
It is Archie Rice, but I want a different name, really.
Oh, John Osborne.
Just explain.
So John Osborne wrote Look Back in Anger. John Osborne wrote A Song and Dance Man about Archie Rice.
It wasn't. That's not what it was called.
Oh, my goodness. It's
recently revived by
Kenneth
Branagh.
Kenneth Branagh,
in London.
It's not the comedian now.
You're much closer now. Yeah. You're talking about her, but.
So what we're looking for, a big word that encompasses
we need,
it.
We need we want you to lead up to a better class of person. You've got all of the basic elements here.
Is a better class of person another play by... No.
No, but it is a work by him.
By John Osborne. Oh, he wrote... It's his book, his autobiography, A Better Class of Person.
It's his autobiography, that's right. So...
Of course. What are we missing?
We're missing a coherent sense of the question as a whole, I think. Though whether I'll get that out of you, I'm not sure.
All right,
let's go through it one by one. So, Retrospective Fury.
Look Back in Anger.
Song and Dance Man.
The Comedian.
You still haven't got the title of that.
The Music...
I think I'm going to have to give this to you. It's The Entertainer.
The Entertainer.
Okay. His play about an end of the pier. The Entertainer. The Diet of Worms, you corrected. Now, why is that a connection to John Osborne? You got the right name. I just want you to perhaps spell it out for me.
Well, because he wrote a play called Luther.
He wrote a play called Luther. And what about the Tom Jones?
Tom Jones, he wrote the screenplay for Tony...
Exactly right.
He Tony wrote the Richardson's play.
Exactly. He wrote the screenplay for the Tony Richardson play.
And then the autobiography.
Yes, so we got there in the end. But it was a long and bumpy road. There were too many clues given there, I think, for me to give you any more than three, I'm afraid, Northern Ireland. Which means, I'm afraid, that Wales have conclusively seen you off with 24 points to 11. Well done to both of you. It means that Wales have now won 4 out of 4 in this year's series, and they can't be caught. Northern Ireland have won 2 and lost 2. Next week's final clash, though, between the North of England and the Midlands could determine who takes the runners-up position. By what's now a long-standing RBQ tradition, all of the questions in next week's programme will be listeners' ideas, and so is this, which is going to be on our web pages for you to look at until we next meet. This is the suggestion of James Smith, who listens to RBQ in Australia. Where would you find the following in control? An error indicator in Microsoft Excel, a Sherlock Holmes story, diphenyl chloro arsine, and a double word score. The words in control are relevant here. I'll give you the full answer next time. Until then, goodbye for now.